is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood, I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said, "I might as well kick it. First class, yo, this is back."
Welcome to Jacksonville University, young Dolph.
Yo, what's up, man? Nice to meet you, dude.
It's a pleasure, dude.
Yeah, I'm excited, but when's the first party?
Got a lot to learn, dude. Not today, dude. We're going to teach you some things, so let's get started. All right, dude. Now that you're a student-athlete, there's some things you got to learn to stay eligible. You're a student first, so let me school you in some academic requirements. How to fin. There are some credit hour and GPA requirements you need to keep in mind in order to remain academically eligible. When you enter your second year of school here, you need to have 24 credits, and 18 of them should have been earned during the fall and spring semesters. Your GPA also must be at 1.8. As you enter your third year, you should have 48 credits, and again, 18 of those should have been earned during the fall and spring semesters. This is also when you need to declare a degree program, and your GPA should now be 1.9 or greater. When you enter your fourth year, you must have 72 credits, and 18 credits of those still have to be earned during the fall and spring semesters. You must have a GPA of at least 2.0. So just to reiterate, when you enter your second year, you have to have a cumulative GPA of 1.8 or above, which is 90% of JU's required GPA. As you enter your third year, you must have at least a 1.9 GPA, which is 95% of JU's required GPA. Finally, when you enter your fourth year, you should have a GPA of 2.0 or higher, which is 100% of JU's required GPA. There are no NCAA GPA requirements for freshmen. However, a student athlete could be NCAA eligible, but still be in danger of losing JU, state, or federal financial aid, so be aware of that. For example, if a student athlete's GPA falls below a 3.0 at the end of an academic year, he or she has an honors scholarship, he or she could lose part or all of the scholarship. If a student athlete has a merit scholarship and falls below a 2.5 at the end of an academic year, he or she will receive a warning. If he or she stays below a 2.5 for a second year, he or she will lose 25% of the award the following year. If a student athlete who receives state and federal financial aid falls below a 2.0 at the end of the academic year, he or she will not be eligible to receive that financial aid the following year without an appeal. If a student's athlete's cumulative GPA falls below certain thresholds after a term, he or she will be put on academic probation. A JU student is put on academic probation after his or her first term below the threshold. He or she has a maximum of 2 additional terms of continued probation. Upon the fourth term, he or she is put on academic suspension. If a freshman's GPA falls between 1.5 and 2.0, he or she will be put on academic probation. As a sophomore, a GPA between 1.8 and 2.0 will land a student on academic probation. Juniors with a GPA between 1.9 and 2.0 will be put on academic probation. Seniors who fall below 2.0 will be suspended for the next term.
Man, that's easy. I'm just gonna do what I did in high school. I sat next to the cute smart girl and cheated on every test.
Young Dolph, you cannot cheat at Jacksonville University, man. If you want to stay eligible, you have to do your own homework, your own tests, your own group projects. And if you are in a group project, you have to make sure you do the legwork. And when you hand in assignments, make sure you cite your sources, because the people will get angry. And if you're not eligible to play your sport, mom's not going to be happy.
Well, I guess I'm just going to have to get my study game up, dude. I'll be sure to be at the Student Athlete Center for Success to get my study hall in.
Yo, man, enough with this academic talk. Are we gonna hit the water today or not?
Ah, dude, in-season practice rules don't start till next week.
But Dude, practice rules?
Yeah, there's a lot
talking
of them.
About practice?
Practice rules, dude. In season, we can practice up to 20 hours a week. And on each day, you're only allowed to practice for 4 hours. And then you have to have one day off. But get it, out of season, you can only practice for 8 hours. And of those 8 hours, two of them are allowed to be individual instruction with your coach. And the best part is, they give us 2 days off. Yeah.
Still, man, that sounds like a lot of practice hours.
Well, see, the thing is, competitions count for 3 hours. And then any scheduled weights is also adds to the weekly hours. But the problem is, any voluntary time you spend in the training room or you get hit in the water a little extra doesn't count. But the best part is, when you're out of school, it's unlimited.
All right. Well, can we at least go for a run today? Is that cool?
Nah, young Joe, we're not going to go for a run. We're going to catch up with your teammates.
All right.
Yeah, so this is the brand new River House.
Yo, man, this looks, it wasn't done when I came here.
Nah, it's pretty nice inside. You got a bar. Classrooms, you know, a little studying, you got a restaurant.
Yeah, I got a nice view out here, dude.
Yeah, it's got some decent food, too. Oh, yo, the boys are here.
Oh, sweet.
Yo, what's up, fellas? How we doing?
What's up? No way. What's up, bro? Good to see you again.
What's
you two,
man?
Fellas. How you been?
Wait, you guys know each other? When'd you guys meet?
Yo, Demontrez hosted me last year for my official visit. It was fun. It was a good time, man.
Yeah, man, me and the guys, man, we had a good time. We took them down to Orlando, brought some alcohol, hit up this huge party at his club.
You took the recruit
to a
party with alcohol? You used your host money to buy alcohol. You guys know how illegal that is? Even if he's 21, you guys gonna have some serious trouble.
Oh, man, I didn't know that, bro. Dang, I could have been the reason you didn't get offered a scholarship, and I could have lost mine.
Ooh.
Next time, I won't be so irresponsible.
Dang.
Yo, does the team do a fantasy football league? Last year, I won $300 from my bracket.
Nah, we don't do a fantasy football league. We only play for bragging rights. We're not allowed to bet here.
You play for bragging rights? Where's the fun in that?
Well, see, you're going to be an NCAA athlete now, and you're not allowed to do intercollegiate betting, professional betting, amateur betting. That's not allowed. You're not allowed to take the money, man.
Man, that's cool. I'll just give my boys the inside scoop. And then they'll win for me.
Young Dolph, you can't do that either. You cannot relay information to anybody about what's going on at your university or other sports teams. That's illegal, and that's going to cause you to be athletic ineligible.
Young men, how are we doing?
Good, nice to see you.
Yeah, never heard back from you about those Jaguars tickets, box seats, remember?
Yeah, I appreciate the offer, I just can't take those.
Well, if you change your mind, you know where to reach me. You all have a great season, all right?
Thank you.
Who was that guy? Because if you don't want those box seats, I'll cop those bad boys.
Dude, that was one of our boosters. He donates a ton of money to the athletic department, and he does a bunch of cool stuff for us, but unfortunately, we can't accept any of it. It's an NCAA violation, and we will get in trouble for it.
Well, maybe he'll let me whip that new Benz he has so I can impress the ladies.
Nah, dude, that's called an extra benefit. You can't accept whips, or you can't accept clothing, haircuts, gifts, money, loans, and free or reduced merchandise.
Man, half the reason I wanted to play in college is so I could receive all of this free stuff.
Dude, I mean, if times are tight and you need some money, just go to FAFSA.
FAFSA?
Yeah, FAFSA. The federal grant money. Go to FAFSA-application.com and fill out an application. See if you can get some extra bucks. Everyone should do this.
Well, I think I'm going to go to the Student Athlete Center for Success and use one of their computers to fill one of those out. I appreciate that, man.
Now that your training's nearly complete, dude, you're almost ready to be a full-time student athlete and a dolphin.
Yo, selfie to commemorate. I'll put it up on the gram.
All right, that's what I'm talking about.
There we go, man. Yo. Excited for the season. Hashtag JU Finn. Hashtag FitFam. Hashtag Bad.
Dude. Watch your language. Now you're representing Jacksonville University. You cannot be posting stuff like that online. Everyone's gonna see it. You gotta be responsible.
Dude, what about the pics from that lit party the other night?
Nah, dude. Not that either. It's not having a good image for us, dude.
Alright. Selfie, no caption.
Dude, no caption's the best. Now you're learning, young Dolph. That's what I'm talking about.
Much better.
fire. I've been watching.